funny. I don't see a resemblance.
Soapnet. Pure soap, 24/7.
Cecile? De Polignac?
How many Ceciles do you know?
One is enough. She's an awful person.
How? Be specific.
She's ill-mannered, she's coarse, duplicitous.
Pretty?
In a cheap kind of a way.
Is she sexy? Does she have a good body?
Her legs are too short.
Oh.
Why are you interested in Cecile de Polignac?
Well, wait till you hear this one. You're not gonna believe it the way you talk about her all the time.
Did she die?
No, Mother.
She's here.
Here?
Yes.
I thought she was in Tanqueray.
Tankier.
Whatever. She's here?
Yes. I called Hilda to find out about Stephen, and she said that Cecile is staying with the Corys.
Rachel has completely lost her mind.
Well, I want you to come with me to pick up Stephen. How do I look?
You look beautiful. I can't believe that she's got the audacity to show her face around here after all the stunts that she pulled.
What stunts?
She slept with every wealthy man in Bay City, for one thing.
She's a gold digger?
She's a gold digger, she's a social climber, she's a tramp.
Oh, Mother, please, don't mince your words.
All she's interested in is money, social position, and she goes after anything in pants. She was hung up on Cass Winthrop for years.
Well, I thought she was in love with Jamie.
If what she feels you can call love.
Do you think she's gonna go after him again?
I wouldn't put anything past her.
It is time I meet the famous Queen Cecile.
Let's go, Mother. I don't want to see
Mother!
Cecile.
Let's go!
I don't want to see Cecile, Victoria! Victoria, come here!
I'll take that.
Oh, is that yours? I had no idea. I was just looking for Cass's number.
Well, you'll have to look somewhere else.
Do you see him often, Rachel?
I found new digs for you, Cecile.
What? That's very sweet of you, and I appreciate it very much. But I'm quite comfortable, actually, where I am.
At Iris's.
Iris's? I heard she was back.
Bay City seems to be attracting filings like a magnet.
I understand why you want me to leave.
Do you?
Yes. I haven't behaved all that well in the past.
You've behaved abominably.
I know. But I want to make amends. That's why I want to stay here, just for a few days, just long enough to set up the Mackenzie Cory Memorial Fund.
That's lovely, Cecile. And you can do that very nicely over at Iris's.
And you can do that very nicely over at Iris's.
Oh, she's always been rude.
Oh, well,
time to get dressed and go find Cass.
Oh, Sharlene, oh, you're here.
Yeah, of course I'm here.
That was so real.
Did you have a bad dream?
You were walking towards me, and I called your name, but you just walked right by.
Well, how rude of me. I'm sorry.
It was like you just didn't even see me.
John, here.
It's like I wasn't even there.
It was just a dream, John.
I know.
Whoa.
What do you suppose it means?
Well, maybe you're nervous about your exam. Come on, I know you've been anxious to hear if you pass. So
no. No, that's not it.
John, you're not having second thoughts about getting married, are you?
Hope that wasn't China.
Taiwan.
They need a queen in Taiwan?
It was Bay City information.
What do you want to know?
Cass Winthrop's telephone number.
Did you get it?
No, it's unlisted.
Why don't you call his office?
Too impersonal.
Tacky.
Ada, you wouldn't happen to know Cass's private phone number, would you?
I wouldn't happen.
I didn't think so.
If I did...
You wouldn't tell me.
You got it right on the first guess.
I really wish that you could find it in your heart to believe that I've changed.
Yeah, well, that's show business.
I have, really, Ada.
I keep getting this thing in my head about leopards and spots and things like that. Hilda, I'll get it. Oh, by the way, Rachel told me to tell you that she has a car arranged to take you to Iris's. Ex-Mrs. Frame, meet almost ex-Mrs. Frame.
Sharlene, how can you even ask a question
John,
like that?
I just thought you
know that I love you and that I really want this marriage.
But your dream, in your dream, you said you felt like you weren't there, like you'd lost your identity.
No, wait, I didn't say anything about losing my identity. I said that I felt like I wasn't there because I was just like I was invisible. You whoosh, walked right by me.
Oh, all right, I know. Maybe it's me. I think sometimes I just keep waiting.
For what?
Oh, for it all to end. I know.
Come
it's
on,
stupid,
Charlie.
No, it's stupid.
I should never have told you about the dream. That's it.
But John, you said you felt like maybe you're losing yourself. Maybe you're afraid of being a couple, a part of a couple.
Now you listen to me. Charlene, I love you more than anyone I've ever loved in my whole life. I want this marriage. I want to marry you.
So you're not nervous about it?
No, of course I'm not nervous. I'd be a little anxious, maybe. A little, excited and passionate and inflamed at times, but I'm not nervous. I'm not.
Okay, fine. Then maybe you're nervous about the same thing that I'm nervous about.
Oh, Shirley, come on. Now, what are you nervous about?
Well, I want to know if you passed the foreign graduate exam.
Wait a minute. Hold it now. I'm the one that's supposed to be nervous about
that. Oh, you said you weren't nervous.
All right, so I lied. I'm a little nervous about it.
Me too.
Why? Oh, all right. I know why. I know why you're nervous, because you think that I failed it, don't you?
Oh, John, no. Now, look, I just said that I was nervous. Can't I be nervous?
No, you can't be nervous, because there's no point in both of us being nervous
about
it.
Well, I can't help it.
You know what it is?
What is
it? It's just too much.
It's too much.
There's too much. We're getting married.
Yeah.
I'm moving into your house.
No, John, it is going to be our house.
Oh, all right. We're getting married. I'm moving into our house, and I'm hopefully embarking on a whole new career. It's too much.
Maybe we should wait to get married.
No. Oh, no. I don't want to. I don't want to wait to. I just want it to be over with.
Oh, well, now there's an interesting choice of words.
Oh, now, come on. You know what I meant.
John, your life is turning upside down.
Yes.
And, of course, you know, my life is moving along just straight and normal as usual, like always.
Yeah. I see. It's not. It's not moving.
No, John, it's not. It's not.
I'm being stupid, aren't I? Aren't you going to say anything? Well?
Well, what?
Well, say something.
John, what can I say? You're a wreck.
Would you be interested in marrying a wreck?
Will you, John, take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wreck?
I will. You know what? I don't think that my life has turned upside down after all. I think that for once, things are turning right side up.
She's sort of kittenish, isn't she? But she's a bit tardy, don't you think? This one's a bit vapid.
Yeah, I think so, maybe.
Do you want something, Vivian, or have you just come in to clear your throat?
I have an announcement.
Well, announce?
I was speaking on the intercom with Mr. Clarence. Mr. Clarence is on the phone. He's asking
Vivian,
me for my
announce.
Recipe for galette burrico. It's a Greek
dessert
made of beam of wheat. Mrs. Rachel Corey's on her way up. Scratch that, she's arrived.
Hello, Cecile.
Hello, Donna, dear.
You here on business of state, or is there some mundane reason for your presence?
Are you asking why I'm here?
Actually, I was just wondering whose life you came to ruin. There aren't too many left, you know.
Oh, but enough about me. Tell me about you. You look wonderful.
Cecile, really?
You do.
Oh, really?
Absolutely. I mean, there's this glow about you, a soft loveliness.
Thank you.
I only hope that when I reach your age, I can look half as good.
I wouldn't count on it. Ada, could I see Stephen now?
I was on my way up there.
You coming, darling?
I'll let you have 5 minutes alone with him.
He's got this neat new trick. He puts his foot behind his ear. I'm telling you, that boy is going to be a world-class gymnast.
That will be all. Thank you, Vivian.
I thought you'd want some gnocchi.
No, I'll call you if I need you.
Nice to see you, Lucas.
Yes.
I've come over to tell you to expect a house guest.
What?
She'll be arriving later today.
Who?
Cecile.
No.
Yes.
Oh, well, that's wonderful. I didn't know she was coming back to Bay City.
Well, actually, she's already arrived. Her Majesty stayed at my house last night, and tonight you may do the honors.
Her Majesty?
Yes, she's the Queen of Tancare.
Well, I'm not so sure about her status. There may have been a spat or a coup.
Who is this person?
She's the daughter of my oldest and dearest friend, the Countess de Polignac. And she's absolutely the sweetest thing.
Well, the sweetest thing gets to stay with you tonight.
I'd be delighted. I'm looking forward to having her. I can't wait for you to meet her, Lucas.
She sounds fascinating.
Oh, there are more apt descriptions of Cecile. Anyway, there was something else I wanted to talk to you about, Iris.
Oh, what's that?
I've been trying to reach you at the office, but it seems you're hardly ever there.
Well, if you will excuse me, I have something I have to do.
Hurry back.
Yeah.
Well, what do you want?
Well, actually, it's something you want.
Which is?
What I found behind the painting of the Red Swan.
Oh, what was it?
I thought I'd show it to you.
Well, I hope there's some batter left.
Oh, no problem. Josie's into her throw the Melba toast across the kitchen table diet.
Oh, come on, Josie. You have to eat
Mama,
something.
Don't start with me.
Okay, all right, fine. John, how many?
Wait.
What are you listening to?
Jumpin' Jack Flash. I haven't heard the song in 20 years.
Hey, I listen to the oldie station. Hear that song all the time.
Isn't that amazing? You listen to a song, it takes you right back to where you were the first time you ever heard it.
Where were you?
When I heard this song?
Yeah.
I was in Vietnam. There was this jockey on Armed Forces Radio used to play it all the time.
Rudy.
Sometimes it would just take you right out of there, even for just a few minutes. Remember the song?
The melody's familiar.
Charlene, what's the matter? You never listen to the radio? This is Jumpin' Jack Flash.
Well, I don't know. Music wasn't a part of my life the way it was.
Oh, that's it. That's it. Now, I've been thinking about this for a long time. The thinking is over. It's time for some action.
John, what are you talking about?
I'm talking about the Stones.
Oh, you mean the Rolling Stones?
Do I mean the Rolling Stones? Only someone who was born in 1970-something could possibly come up with a question like that. Of course I mean the Rolling Stones.
Hey, wait a minute. They're on tour, right?
Right. Look, I'm going to go and get some tickets for all of us.
Great. Where are you going?
Far out.
I'm
going
to go and get us all tickets for the Rolling Stones concert.
Well, cool, man. I'd love to go.
Well, great.
Well, I'm not sure I'm the rock concert type.
You're not the rock. Well, Sharlene, listen. There are rock concerts,
yes.
And then there are Stones concert. Mm-hmm. This is a Stones concert. That's a different. Could you tell her, please?
Hey, I'm going downtown. I'm going to get us some tickets.
Oh, wait a minute. Okay. I don't want to sit around here and watch you eat all day, so I think I'll join you.
Great. I'd like the company. Matt, do you want to come?
No, we'll have 11 o'clock. School, you know. Oh, sorry.
Understand.
Well, now, wait a second. How about breakfast?
We were just
I'm sure that Matthew can polish off whatever John and I were going to eat.
Come on, Josie. I'm sure we can find a takeout Melba toast stand on the way. Let's go before the house.
A photograph?
It's an enlargement of part of a photograph.
Oh, it's Daddy. Oh, he looks so young and so handsome.
Do you know when it was taken?
No, I don't.
Well, do you know where it was taken?
No, I've never seen it before.
What about the man in the picture with him? Do you recognize him?
I can barely make him out, no.
Are you absolutely sure?
No, I've never seen him before either. I'm sorry. Where's the rest of the picture?
That's all I found. I would like to ask you some questions.
About what?
About your father's early life.
How early?
From college on.
I thought you knew everything there was to know.
I don't.
Well, you know, he graduated from Dartmouth, and then after the war, he went to graduate school in journalism.
Where?
Northwestern. Then he got his M.A., then he went to work for a newspaper, and he used to say it took him about a week to get tired of working for someone else. So he started his own newspaper, and he never told you any of this?
Some of it. He said it would bore me. The newspaper was a success.
Oh, yes. Well, why wouldn't it be? Daddy willed it to be. It was the beginning of Cory Enterprises.
The period from the war to when he started the newspaper, did he ever tell you anything more specific about that period of time?
No. No, he didn't. He didn't talk about that time at all.
No, he didn't with me either.
It's unsettling, isn't it? It's unsettling to think that there's a whole part of Daddy's life and we don't know about it.
Somebody must know.
Well, why do you think he hid this behind the painting?
I have no idea. I'm not even certain he was the one who hid it. But I'm going to find out.
He was so wonderfully good looking, wasn't he?
Yes, he certainly was.
I miss him.
I know. Thanks for your help.
Rachel, would you mind? Could I keep the photograph, please?
Yes, of course you can. Mitch and I made several copies. Iris, if anything else about any of this occurs to you, you will let me know, won't you?
Yes, of course.
Thank you.
Rachel? Thank you.
Medical exam results.
I'm going crazy waiting for you to get home.
Oh, wow.
Oh, come on. Aren't you going to open them? Open them.
Yeah, I guess I better. Yeah. Open it.
Read it to me.
Dear Dr. Hudson, we inform you.
John.
I passed.
Oh, my God.